Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Thursday, September 29th, 2011. In the pre-market this morning at 7 a.m. on the East Coast, we do have stock index futures slightly above fair value. They've come off their morning highs so far, and we've got gold and crude oil basically unchanged in the pre-market, so not a lot of guidance from the futures in the pre-market on Thursday morning. Now, we saw some selling going into the close on Wednesday. That's never good. We don't like to see the pros unload their positions going into the close, but that's what they did yesterday. Not a lot of damage from that selling, though. We came back down to the lower channel line. That's neutral. We're looking for a breakout here. Still haven't got it yet. We've been in a tight range for a while, so if it feels like the market's been treading water, it certainly has. Since early August, we're down at the lows at 10,625 and up at the highs at 11,562. So we've been trading in that range, and a couple of patterns have come out of that. Of course, the first one that a lot of people see, the bulls certainly see, is the double bottom. And we saw that in looking at the DAX yesterday. So the bulls are looking at that double bottom, hoping that since we retested the lows, that we should be able to move higher from here. A lot of the bears are looking at a head and shoulders pattern that's developed. And, you know, if that pattern executes, if we break down from here, then a two-line move down to 10,000 would not be unreasonable given the pattern. So if we do break down, 10,000 would be a reasonable target to the downside. Now, I'm watching the continuation of a lower high here. And so we've got a series of lower highs have developed. And just to draw a couple of trend lines here, and we're waiting for the market to break out through those trend lines, which should act as resistance as the market moves higher. So if this week's high holds, we've made another lower high, and that, of course, is bearish. Take a look at the VIX. The VIX moved higher yesterday. Looking for it to break down below 30, just like the Dow. We've been in a tight range between 31.25 and 43.75, and looking for a breakout of that range. The bonds traded lower yesterday, but actually closed higher on the day, so no more money coming out of the bond market yesterday, and the U.S. dollar still on a buy signal. Gold was down yesterday, so it's trading between the 100 and 200-day moving average. 200-day moving average is acting as support. A lot of people are watching that. Looking at copper, it moved down yesterday once again. You know, that's the global economic barometer. That's not going in the right direction. And taking a look at Thursday's trading in China, we made a lower low last night. Taking a look at the major indexes, no changes here. The S&P 500, a similar situation to the Dow. We saw weakness in bank stocks, and you know, we saw some strength in the European bank stocks, of course, the Canadian bank stocks. Basically, most of them got back on buy signals. The major indexes, the major banking indexes all got back on buy signals, but we saw weakness yesterday that took us back down towards the lower channel line. Looking at the NASDAQ, no change there. No change for the SOX index. Came down below the lower channel yesterday once again. So did the Russell. So did the ZAX. So these indexes ran up, tested the upper channel line, and came back down this week. And we're looking for those breakouts. We're looking for the close above to give us some buy signals here. No buy signal for energy. Of course, nothing going on in gold right now. The index came down to the previous low yesterday. No change for the transports. No change for the euro, of course. And no change for any of the major commodities. Looking at copper, looking at gold, looking at the GLD. If we break down here, we're holding support around the 156.25 level. If we break down, 150 is our next target to the downside. Looking at the SLV, if the SLV breaks down through the recent low, then 25 is our next target to the downside for the SLV. Looking at crude oil, no change there, no change for gasoline, and no change for natural gas. Moving on to Thursday's roadmap, using the 60-minute charts as our guide, you can see we've now reversed. We traded through the top of the open gap, so that open gap has the market's going to ignore that from now on. So we've got the pressure zone there, and we rallied off the pressure zone. So we've got a couple of lines we're looking at here, a downtrend line and an uptrend line. Those are coming together, and so we're looking for a breakout above that to take the market lower, or a breakdown below the uptrend line to move the market higher. And on Thursday, we're going to remain bearish on the stock market as long as the VIX stays above the 37.80 level. If it closes below that on an hourly basis, then we're looking for a new intraday sell signal for the VIX, and an intraday sell signal for the VIX would be bullish for the stock market. Taking a look at the hourly panic zone charts for the S&P 500, the early warning signal, we've moved lower since then. We are now back below the flypaper channel. We've got a nice uptrend line up there at 1190, and downtrend line. And so if we take out that downtrend line, that would certainly be bullish for the market. We're going to remain bearish on the S&P 500 and the rest of the U.S. stock market on Thursday as long as we remain below the 1176.57 level. If we start closing above that, then that would give us an intraday buy signal and we become bullish with the goal of running up to retest the recent high. Okay, that's all for Thursday morning, folks. Have a great day and we'll talk to you again on Friday morning.